94 constituencies, 12 states and union territories, and over 1300 candidates. That's phase 3 of Lok Sabha elections for you. Now remember, out of the 94 seats, Surat in Gujarat, PM Modi's home ground, has already been won by BJP unopposed. And Mukesh Kumar Chandrakant Dalal is the BJP leader of Surat. Also remember that all 25 seats from Gujarat will be going for polls in this phase of the general election. And therefore we could say that the political fate of Gujarat is either going to be a yay or a nay for BJP. Also apart from Gujarat, seats from Assam, Goa, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Bihar and Uttar Pradesh will also be contested. And as I said, in phase 3 of Lok Sabha elections, most eyes will be on Gujarat, especially Gandhinagar, because Gandhinagar has been a BJP fortress since 1989, especially under leaders like L.K. Advani and Arjun Bihari Vajpayee. Now this time again, Amit Shah will be contesting from the region against Sonal Patel from Congress. Now another state that's going to grab attention is Karnataka, as Shimoga, Dharwad and Haveri have had BJP MPs for over 2 decades now. And this time Prahlad Joshi, India's coal minister, is going to contest from Dharwad for the 4th time. And Basavaraj Bommai, the former chief minister of Karnataka, will contest from Haveri. And Shimoga will have former CM B.S. Yediyurappa's son, Yediyurappa Raghavendra, contesting for the seat. Also remember that voting in a few states in India has been completely concluded. Like Tamil Nadu, Kerala and half of Karnataka in the south, most of northeast except Assam, Rajasthan and Uttarakhand in the north, and by the end of this phase, even Gujarat will be done. Therefore, who do you think will win the ultimate general elections 2024? Let us know.